request everyone to close your eyes. Now imagine, your parents are coming home after work, smiling. They come through the door, put their laptop bags on the couch and call for you. But there's no reply. They call again, a little louder this time, but again, no answer. And that's when they hear a dripping sound. That's when they run up to your bathroom only to find your limp, lifeless body in a pool of cold, red blood. You had killed yourself. The dark depression that you had refused to talk about had finally taken your life. Your mom screams your name, hugging your corpse tightly, begging you to open your eyes while your dad tries to get her away, tears streaming down his face. Then he sees a note in the same hand that you tore open to let your soul escape. "I'm sorry," it says. If only that was enough to stop the guilt and sadness that would eat your parents alive for the rest of their sad, miserable lives. Open your eyes. According to the American Foundation for Suicide Prevention, globally there is one death every 40 seconds because of suicide. That means by the end of just our 1 5-minute speech, around 7 people would be dead. You are all amazing, amazing people who deserve much, much more than having their life stripped away because they couldn't get help. If you have any reason to believe that you are not worth it, please talk to someone. And if someone finds the courage to come to you, help them. I am not an expert, I have no PhD about this, but I am very passionate. I have put in hours and hours of research, and I have read a lot of comments from people who have suffered depression and have thought of suicide, so I do have an idea of their perspective too. Suicide is preventable and depression is defeatable if help is received at the right time. These are not small issues. It will not just go away if you ignore it. Save.org says that suicide is the second leading cause of death for 15 to 19 year olds, only beaten by accidents. More kids die because of suicide than cancer, heart disease, AIDS, birth defects, strokes, pneumonia, influenza, and chronic lung disease combined. Can you imagine that? Each day, more than 3,470 suicide attempts are done by kids. Depression is the number one cause of suicide untreated. More than 67% of kids who are depressed do not get help. Research shows that when kids turn to suicide, it's because they want to escape a bad situation, not because they actually want to die. Suicide is a very serious problem and needs to be addressed. Fortunately, it is preventable. But what about society? What about all the shame that comes with accepting that you are depressed or you are having suicidal thoughts, you may ask? While looking at 10 reasons not to commit suicide by logical spiritualism, I saw so many comments talking about what society thinks and how people can come out because they feel that society will call them a burden to their family or that they bring the society down. Well, I want to say society is us. We are what make a society. If we could reduce the negative stigma around suicide and depression, so many more people could come out and we could help them. And when someone is depressed, they do not need an entire society to get better. All they need is that one person who will be there for them and let them know that it is okay. What society thinks does not matter in the end. If there is even a single person willing to help, it will be okay. We can do this together, and here's how. To help someone who is depressed, you need to know the signs to see how someone is depressed. Childmind.org and HealthGuide.org say that people who are depressed are often irritable, don't want to go out, lose interest in things that they previously loved doing, students' grades often drop, they can't concentrate, and they feel worthless and hopeless. Worst of all, they start feeling guilty about things that they didn't even do. Here's how you can help them. You should be supportive. Show them the bright side. Sympathize with them. Put yourself in their shoes and see how you can make them feel better. Make sure that they know that you're there for them. Talk openly. Let them know that they are not a bad person just because they have depression. Convince them to talk to an adult before you go yourself. Unless they are thinking about having suicidal thoughts, then call 911 as soon as possible or tell a trusted adult. If you have depression, know that you are not alone. You will get through. This pain does not last forever. Talk to someone. Please know that you deserve better than going through this alone. Suicide is not the only way. Mental illness is not a choice, but recovery is. It is not easy, takes a lot of courage and bravery, but it is possible. Depression is not the end, and once you defeat it, your life will get better. There are so many people who have overcome depression. You might have heard of them. Some of them, Ellen DeGeneres, J.K. Rowling, and even Abraham Lincoln. J.K. Rowling once said, "The knowledge that you have emerged wiser and stronger from setbacks means that you are ever after secure in your ability to survive. You will never truly know yourself or the strength of your relationships until both have been tested by adversity. Such knowledge is a true gift. For all that is painfully won and all that's worth, and it has been worth more than any qualification that I have ever earned. You can fight depression and it can make you a better person." Just when a caterpillar thinks that its world is ending, it turns into a butterfly. But for this to happen, we need to work together. Now, I would request you to close your eyes again. Imagine your parents at your funeral. They call it graduation. So your parents are at your college graduation. There is a beautiful blue sky. Birds are chirping in trees. You are on the stage getting your diploma while they're clapping with all their hearts. Tears of joy streaming down their faces. "That's my child," they say proudly. "You had done it. You had fought the demon that was depression and you had won. The dark part of your life helped you appreciate the good even more and motivated you to be the strong person that you have become. You absolutely love your life." Open your eyes. Suicide is preventable and depression is defeatable if help is received at the right time. Suicide and depression aren't a small thing. You can't ignore them and they do need treatment just like physical illnesses. We can reduce teen suicide rates together. I am willing to do my part. Are you?